As you know, the November elections are rapidly approaching. This is the midterm election where the Democrats are vying for control of Congress. Now, one of the districts that could flip from Republican to Democrat is New Jersey's 2nd Congressional District, a seat currently occupied by Republican Frank Lobiondo. Now, Frank Lobiondo not running for re-election, and the two candidates running, one, Senator Jeff Van Drew, the Democrat, and the Republican Seth Grossman. Controversy exploded over this Facebook post. This is from a white nationalist site. The Republican candidate, Seth Grossman, reposted it only to get hammered by the media and his Democratic opponent, Senator Jeff Van Drew. I had a chance to catch up with Senator Van Drew, and I asked him, do you think your opponent is a racist?
I don't think it's necessarily appropriate as a leader, as someone who wants to be a congressman, to be reading and sharing information that basically comes from white supremacist types of organizations.
All right, joining me now is that Republican candidate, Seth Grossman. Seth, welcome to Chasing News. How are you?
Yeah, thanks for inviting me.
So what happened? How did you get into a situation where you reposted this clearly racist language?
Well, it was the summer, actually it's December of 2014. This was the summer of the Ferguson riots, police officers getting killed because the media had this relentless narrative, fake narrative of hands up, don't shoot, as if every police officer in America was going out looking for an unarmed black helpless teenager to murder him. In December 30th, I happened to see a post that was shared to me by Colonel Alan West, former congressman, black of course, and pointing out some of the thugs that that police officers encountered every day and night out in the street. I read the first few paragraphs. It seemed to make sense. It matched what I experienced when I was a lawyer in the criminal justice system. I shared it. I said, oy vey, look what this country's coming to. And it was forgotten for 3.5 years until when I became a candidate for Congress. Media Matters looked at everything I posted on Facebook for the past 10 years. They found about 24 posts that were inflammatory, and this was one of them. What I did not realize, at the bottom of the post, there were some very ugly racist generalizations, which I totally despise, but I didn't realize it at the time. I apologize. Other people got that same post from Colonel West. You know, when you get a post from a friend, a lot of times you let your guard down. I did it this time. I apologize. I don't believe anything.
All right, let's bring in our A-plus panel to break this down. Republican Matt Rooney from the Save Jersey blog back with us, and Lisa Durden, pop culture expert. Lisa, yeah. I'm going to start with you.
Well, I have a question for Mr. Grossman. So can you accept the fact that there are lots of people of color and lots of people in your own party, the Republican Party, who think you're racist because of statements like diversity is crap, the Muslim faith or Islam is cancer, that the African-American oppression is overrated, and things of that nature? Do you see how people can see that you are a racist, or they think you're a racist because of those statements?
Of course, because that's why the media does it. However, however, if you would look at each incident that came up to understand why I said what I did, it would be fairly reasonable.
Well, you just said, Mr. Grossman, that you reposted things from a friend. You reposted something from a friend that you didn't notice all the other racial epithets and things within that post because you let your guard down.
Well, Lisa, let's go back to what you said.
I would never let my guard down on something somebody says.
I want to go back to what Lisa
I read
said,
everything.
Let's talk about that. The statement you made about diversity being crap.
Yeah, right. That was.
And Kwanzaa being phony.
It is phony.
But Kwanzaa's not phony.
Well, wait. Let's.
It was made up.
Black. I'm black.
Hold on, Lisa. Hold on 1 second. Let him answer. Go ahead.
Well, Kwanzaa was invented by a black racist in the 1960s. Why? Because he didn't want blacks and whites celebrating Christmas together as a time of goodwill. So to divide America, to get Americans angry at each other, it was in his agenda to do that. That's why Kwanzaa was invented.
Let me bring Matt in. Matt, so let me ask you, the National Republican Congressional Committee has dropped Seth. They're not going to help him.
Wonderful.
I would say they were probably not going to get involved anyway, given the polling.
But they were involved.
What do you say?
Is it a
fair conversation? You're hearing what both of them are saying. What do you think?
Well, this conversation is really an illustration of the problem. On the one hand, you have Seth Grossman, who there's some things that he stands for that I agree with, but at the same time, when you're a public figure, which you've been for a while, and you share articles, you got to read them
Thank
and make,
you.
And make sure
Thank you.
that if you don't agree with everything in the article, you distinguish that. At the same time, you have people like my friend Lisa, who sees on these things, and when there are huge other issues out there to talk about, it just becomes all Republicans are racist because one person made a stupid decision.
I never said all Republicans are racist, so don't misquote me. First of all, I'm not having this conversation. Chasing News is, and I'm
on the panel.
But see,
that's the problem.
But no,
let me finish. We can't have a constructive conversation about something like diversity.
He answered it very eloquently, and I continue.
All right, so let me.
You're having an issue with that.
All right, so let me just end with you. Last point, Seth. You're going to stay in the race?
Absolutely. We have to have these conversations because if you have critical issues and everybody's afraid to even talk about it because they might make a mistake or might be called racist, then nobody talks about the things that are most important and problems don't get solved.
I agree that we have to have these conversations because sometimes we misunderstand a person,
Seth.
So we
Thank
did
you.
Talk.
All right.
But he's still a racist.
This conversation will definitely continue as we head closer to November.